Hey YouTube, so I'm doing something a little bit different with my hair today. Normally after I wash it, I just rake through the product, scrunch in some gel, and then I diffuse my hair. But I'm home today and I just wanted to, I guess, test something out. So what I'm actually doing, I just washed my hair, I shampooed it and I conditioned it and rinsed out the conditioner. And I am just applying the product to my hair. And I sectioned my hair off into a bunch of sections. The back is already done. I'll show you that after I show you what I'm doing. So I'm just going to take a section of gray hair. Ignore that. Small section of hair like that. Just pin that back. All right, this has no product on it. And then I'm taking some of the SheaMoisture Curl Enhancing Smoothie. I'll put a little bit of that. Just a little dab in my hand, like that. And then I'm taking some Kinky Curly Curl and Custard, because you know these two have become like my favorite combination lately. And just a little bit also. I'm putting that in my hand, mixing them together. And I'm taking this part and I'm just smoothing it in. And I never really do this. I always see people who have tighter curl textures put the product in this way in their hair. And I don't know, I never do it, so kind of want to elongate my hair a little bit, so I'm just trying something new, and if I don't like it, I'll just do my hair over. I'm taking my Denman brush, and I'm just brushing it through one time, and just letting it fall. It's kind of, after a couple of seconds, it just curls up a little bit. Alright, so I'm going to take another section. I'm not going to bore you and do my whole head through this video. I just wanted to do a couple sections to show you. And then I'll show you the results. So here's another section here about, can you see? About this much. Okay. Take a little bit more of the SheaMoisture Curl Enhancing, a little bit of the Kinky Curly, and obviously I have time on my hands today. Mix it together. Then take that section. Smooth it in, and then comb my Denman brush, and then just drop it in the cheek, I guess. Alright, so let me show you what the parts that I've done already. The back part of my hair, okay? Hopefully you can see it. Hope you can see it. You can't tell. See? So I'm kind of seeing if I can elongate my curls at all, but alright, so I'm going to continue doing that section by section until my whole head is done. And then I'll check back in with you. Just finished putting all the product in my hair and brushing it through the Denman. So just want to show you how it looks with the product applied. And keep in mind, my hair is still like really, really wet. So here it is. Alright, so what I'm going to do, because I feel like it's just going to be extra flat, I think I'm going to diffuse, and it's going to take too long to air dry. I'm just going to diffuse it for a couple minutes, and then I'll probably let it air dry. And, yeah, okay? Well, my bitties, you know the saying, if it ain't broke, then don't fix it. So, my hair is, like, probably like 95% dry. What I end up doing is I diffuse for like, maybe like 3 minutes, to be honest, just so it wasn't sopping wet, dripping down my back. And I let it air dry for a couple hours, and this is what I got, a jerry curl. I got my own jerry curl. Now I remember why I like to diffuse so much. See how it looks? It's extremely shiny, I must say. However, will I be going out in public like this? I don't think so. So, I haven't touched it or anything. I just, I'm sorry, I'm looking in the mirror right now. And alright, I'm going to scrunch out the crunch a little bit. It might cause frizz, but at this point, it can't get any worse. I mean, I don't know, it has good curl definition, per se. But it looks like a modern day Jerry curl. Needs to be fluffed. You know I love volume, and this is just, oh, it's crunchy. Wow. Okay, it is still a little bit wet. Just a little bit. Anyway, you know I like volume, and this is just not my norm right now. But, you know, I'm trying to think outside the box, you know, just do something different. I don't know. Well, once I fluff it up a little bit, looks a little bit better. It just seems so plastered to my head. Okay, this is looking better. Maybe because it was so crispy from the Kinky Curly Curl and Custard. See, when I use the Kinky Curly Curl and Custard and I diffuse, it's not crunchy at all for me. So, I guess it's just different when you air dry, it gets crunchy. Okay, this is looking a lot better so far. Can you see it starting to expand some? Okay, this side is flat though. Maybe I need to flip my hair. Look at those curls though. That is kind of cute. So this is, yeah. Okay. That's kind of cute. Let's see. Make this quick. Alright, I think I'm going to flip my hair upside down. Let me get up. Okay. Shake a little bit. Come on. Lift. Okay, it's looking better. Alright, now this looks cute. Yeah. I can deal with this. Now it looks much better than it when I didn't scratch up. I look like Annie or something. Like, aww, how cute. So what do you think? This is how it looks. Let me show you the back. I haven't even seen the back. But I'll let you see it, I guess. Tell me what you think. So this is my something different. I'll take a few pictures and I'll post it at the end of the video. But not too bad. Much better now that I fluffed it out a little bit. Aw, I like the little curls under here. Look, along with my nice shiny gray hair. Hi, friend. Okay. Alright, see ya.
Aren't even in the past, and yet you see the picture clear as day. I don't know why you're.